Sense organs in insects. It's a bit complicated chapter, but I will tell you superficially. Sense organs are nothing but these are the sense cells involved in detection and perception of any changes in the environment. Mainly, there are five types of sense organs present in insects. First one is mechanoreceptors. These are the sense cells involved in detection of pressure and contact. Audioreceptors involved in detection of sound. Chemoreceptors involved in chemicals detection. Photoreceptors are the visual organs involved in detection of light. Thermoreceptors involved in detection of heat. Let's see one by one. First one is mechanoreceptors. These are the sense organs involved in detection of mechanical distortions like pressure and vibration. So these are the four types of mechanoreceptors. First one is trichoid sensilla, hair-like structure, sensitive to touch, that is proprioceptors, mainly located on antenna and tarsi. Second one is campaniform sensilla. These are dome-shaped sensilla inserted into dome-shaped cuticle, sensitive to pressure, mainly located on leg joints and wing bases. Third one is caudatonal organs. These consist of specialized cells called as scolopedia, sensitive to vibration and located on leg joints, antenna and wings. Last one is multipolar stretch receptors. These consist of multipolar neurons associated with the muscles. For example, cysto-cyst-like organ located at the terminal abdomen of tulipidae larva. Another example is Palmen's organ located on tracheal system of Epipteropteran nymphs. Next one is chemoreceptors. These are the receptors involved in the detection of chemicals. The receptors may be unipolar, that means they detect the chemical in solid or liquid form, are called as gustatory receptors, whereas multipolar means these receptors detect the chemicals in vapor form, are called as olfactory receptors. These are the four main chemoreceptors present in insects. Sensilla, trichoidea, these are hair-like structure, most abundant chemoreceptors, which acts as olfactory and gustatory function. Next one is sensilla vesiconica. These are peg-like or cone-like organs, mainly involved in olfactory and gustatory function. Sensilla coeloconica. These are pig peg-like organs. It acts as olfactory and carbon dioxide receptors. And the fourth one is sensilla placodia. These are plate-like structures which performs olfactory function. Next one is auditory organs. These organs involved in detection of sound. First one is tympanal organs. These are located on first abdominal segment of Saturn grasshoppers, whereas four tibia of Langhorne grasshoppers. And second one is auditory hairs. These are mainly present in Lepidoptera and Orthoptera. And third one is Johnston's organ. So in male Aedes mosquito, these Johnston organs acts as auditory organs, that is sound hearing organ. And fourth one is pilifer. These are mainly located on second labial palpi of hawk moth. And next one is thermoreceptors. These thermoreceptors detect the variation of temperature, and they mainly located on antenna and maxillary pulp. Let's see the photoreceptors. Larval holometabolous insects have one or more single lens eyes located on either side of the head, which helps to detect the form, color and the movement. These eyes are called as lateral oculi or stemmata. Next one is dorsal oculi. In most of the adult insects and larval hemimetabolous insects have the dorsal oculi, which helps in perception of light to maintain the diurnal rhythm, but not involved in the image formation. These varies from 0 to 3 in numbers. And next one is compound eyes. Compound eyes are made up of number of individual units called as ommatidia. These ommatidia are present in adult pterygotan insects as well as immature hemimetabolous insects. Let's see the ommatidia. Ommatidia is differentiated into light gathering and light detecting part. If you look at the structures, corneal lens is present, which is a transparent cuticle secreted by carnegie cells. And below the corneal lens, this one is a crystalline cone, which are secreted by Semper cells. And these two are primary pigmentary cells. And this below the crystalline cone, this one is rhabdom, and on other side of the rhabdom are retinalar cells, and these are the secondary pigmentary cells. When light enters the corneal lens, light detecting part containing light sensitive photoreceptors called as retinular cells. These retinular cells detect the wavelength of light. The light sensitive region of retinular cells is the rhabdomere. This rhabdomere contains light detective pigments called as rhodopsin. These retinular cells are surrounded by the secondary pigmentary cells so that each ometidia functionally isolated from other ometidium. There are two types of ometidium are present in insects. In diurnal insects, the ometidium is referred to as photopic or opposition eye because the base of the crystalline cone is in opposite to the rhabdom. When light enter into the crystalline cone and it directly falls on the this rhabdom. When light rays, you can see here, when light rays enters the crystalline cone at an angle, so these are observed by the pigmentary cells, that is primary pigmentary cells, which are present on either side of the crystalline cone, so that it prevents the light entering into the adjacent cells. And in photopic eyes, individual ometidia serves as an individual visual unit which produces only that portion of the visual scene. So the images formed in these eyes are with the high resolution, and the distinct image is formed. Next one, we can compare the eyes of insects which are active during night time, referred to as scotopic or superposition eyes. So ometidium structure is similar to photopic ometidia, except the open space present between the crystalline cone and retinular cells. So this cleared zone is called as crystalline track. In scotopic eyes, incoming light is focused on the base of the crystalline cone and conducted to the rhabdom by the crystalline track. So this scotopic ometidia very sensitive to change in light intensity which occur during day and night time. During daytime, this scotopic eyes detect the light similar to photopic ometidia, that is similar to diurnal insects. As night approaches, an intensity of light decreases, which results in the contraction of primary pigmentary cells upward. That means during night time, when the light intensity decreases, the primary pigmentary cells present on either side of the crystalline cone, which contracts upwards, which is seems to be the primary pigmentary cells are absent. When light enters into the crystalline cone and reaches the rhabdomere, you can see this. So these are the light rays which enter into the ometidium at an angle, and it enters into the adjacent ometidia because of the upward contraction of primary pigmentary cells. So which forms the superimposed images are indistinct images, which is of in low resolution. So you can see this type of eyes in nocturnal insects. Next one is types of compound eyes based on the presence and nature of crystalline cone. First one is U-cone. In this case, the ometidium in which Semper cells produces hard intracellular crystalline cone. So you can see this type of compound eyes in Lepidoptera and Hymenoptera. In pseudocone, the Semper cells are filled with liquid rather than this crystalline cone. You can see in Diptera. O-cone means Semper cells do not produce a separate lens. So you can see in Coleoptera. whereas exocone means Semper cells do not produce a crystalline cone but replaced by an extension of inner surface of the cornea. So you can see in Dermistidae. So that's it about sense organs. Please do subscribe and like my videos. If you have any doubts, please comment below the video. Thank you.